Meghan has a new business brain fart. So pre-Harry, we had the Tig. Post-Harry, Netflix, Spotify, Clever Coffee, Lemonada, American Riviera Boring, and now drumroll, handbags. Yes, the Dutch ass is flogging Cesta Collective, a basket bag company. Apparently, she's invested after Googling looking for brands to attach herself to, and I quote, "When other people are online looking for things or reading things, I'm trying to find great new designers to leech off." Oh, sorry, she didn't say that. "Great new designers to destroy." Oh, she didn't say that either. What's wrong with me? Well, I'll paraphrase. "Great new designers to use for her own ends, especially in other territories. I can feel more tours coming on." Meghan apparently became aware of her power to flog brands after her first royal engagement with Haz. That resulted in the handbag she was carrying selling out in 11 minutes. So they had two in stock? This was referred to as the Meghan effect, and she didn't say this, but I think she filed it away for future reference under "I want a cut of the action." So now she seeks to resurrect that idea. We seem to have gone full circle, don't we? Back to the days of the Tig, fashion, food, freeloading. But this time with pseudo-thrones, fawning politicians, and guaranteed coverage by the glossies, Harper's, People, Vogue, Grazia, Marie Claire. So I guess one could say she's stepped up her profile a tad. Rachel calls this chapter "Investing in Herself." Well, one could ask, when hasn't she? So let's look at this. From Deal or No Deal Suitcase Girl, a brief stint as a royal intern, and now an influencer. Heady stuff. Well, if it makes you happy, darling, it's easier to aim low. Harry, meanwhile, is heading to New York City, kicking off September 22nd. He thought he'd organised a very clever ambush, timing it to coincide with his big brother's visit. Except William isn't going. I imagine someone's head rolled over that one. Gotta watch those red herrings being drip-fed to your underlings, Haz. Do you really think the palace will ever tell you what's really going on? Suck it up, Friar Tuck. Gotcha. So, wah, in paperback, time for slap-bang in the middle of Chogham, the Commonwealth Head of Government's meeting in Samoa. How thoughtful, how kind, how typical. Pa will be playing his part as government's aim to secure a peaceful and sustainable future for the Commonwealth's 1.5 billion young people. Well, that's the stated purpose on the website anyway. And the media's focus will be on Harry's poor performing paperback. It will be poor performing. Who in their right mind is going to buy it? Especially if there's nothing new. Well, that's what we've been spun. However, I cynically suspect that it will be announced that there are some new juicy tidbits forthcoming. Maybe the announcement was supposed to provoke some sort of response from the royals. Maybe Harry has told the publishers, "If they wish me happy birthday, we'll publish the original book. If they ignore me, gloves off." They won't respond, Harry. They don't take kindly to implicit threats and blackmail. You should know that by now. You've tried it so often. From Meghan finding her diary in the Frogmore Cottage sock drawer to announcing you had 400 more malicious pages to put into a second book. They just don't care anymore. Wah has been thoroughly dissected and proven to be quite the work of fiction. So publish and be damned, sir. I wonder if anyone at the palace has ever given any real thought into what Haz and Megs really want. What would satisfy? What would make them go away? The PR bombardment and implicit threats continue, and it makes me wonder, will this ever stop? Or will they still be airing their endless grievances on their 80th birthdays? That's an interesting concept, the aging Sussexes. I guess Haz could become an ambassador for hair regrowth products or plugs, and Megs could move into designer dentures or veneers. Or maybe she could open a sweet little roadside stall in Melodramacito with wholesale jam she's stuck her label on. I'm still waiting to see what the Aero promo was really all about. Remember that ball-gowned appearance down the end of a dimly lit hall? Lady in Black, who apparently cooks. Was it supposed to have a meaning, some relevance, or was it just designed to attract attention? Imagine having a life of endless launches, businesses that never get off the ground, charity initiatives that lack any plan or purpose, the endless, exhausting, grinding grift. But they're so good at it. The grift, I mean. Bye. Ball-gowned appearance.